Christ is risen. Hallelujah. I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and I welcome you to our worship here at St. Paul on this, the fifth Sunday in the season of Easter. A warm welcome to those who are listening with us this morning, as well as those of you who are watching this worship on our YouTube channel. There are lots of announcements in your insert and on the e-news that's sent out every week, so please make sure that you take the time to read all of them. As part of our worship today, we are going to do a little bit of celebration as we welcome Stephanie, Marcus, Cheryl, Colleen, and Jeremy as new members to our congregation. And unfortunately, Cheryl and Jeremy are not able to be here, but we will include them anyway, whether they like it or not. Today is also Faith Life Sunday, and Peg has an announcement. Well, actually, she has two announcements today, one now and one later on. Anybody else? Talents of beauty. What are talents that bring beauty to the world? An artist. What are some talents? I'll get them close. What are some talents of function? Being a good listener from that too. Those are some examples of the kinds of gifts that God gives us. You have a piece of paper in front of you. You are not bragging. This is an ability or abilities God gave you. Take some time and think about it and list them on here. We'll hang them on the wall so we can all see collectively how we could use our talents for the good of God. Thank you, and I'll see you again at the end. The flowers on the altar and the chancel flower this morning are in celebration of Stephanie Cortez's summa cum laude graduation from University of Detroit Mercy's Honors Program. Congratulations to Steffi, and thank you to the Cortez family for the flowers. And more announcements. Outreach has an interesting project going, and Kathy is going to tell us about it.
Good morning. Can you hear me? Okay. Does this look good on me?
A little bit small. All
right. Now, I admit it looks a little small, but I know of a group that is providing daily needs to foster children, and that is the Macomb Foster Closet. And foster families can come there to get items like this lovely, this lovely pajama set for a toddler. So we are collecting infant and toddler items, clothing, to take to the Macomb Foster Closet in the next few weeks. We've had this announcement out, and I'd like to get in whatever anybody else would like to give us. We're also supporting Samaritas's Foster and Families First program. So we'd like to be able to maybe buy a stroller or a car seat or something like that to give to them too. So, if you would like to bring in anything for clothing-wise, new or used, clean used, clothing for toddlers or infants, please do so, and you can leave it in our on our pew. If you're interested in helping support strollers and car seats, you can use one of the giving envelopes there, put your check or whatever in there, and please just mark it a baby, and the counters will know what to do with it, okay? So I learned that you are really good about supporting children and the homeless, and so this is one way for you to continue your work to us. Second, real quick, excuse me, Pastor, homeless, Motor City Mitten has now got someone to put on a golf outing type event at Lockmore on July 25th. So if you golf and would like to support them, we'll be putting out the blurb for that so that you can sign up, golf, have dinner, and this all goes to Motor City Mitten for the homeless rescue. So thanks.
Let your sermon begin. Turn on the microphone, it helps. Let the sermon committee small group session continues today and on Thursday evening. The small group session today will meet upstairs in the Jerusalem room. If you haven't signed up but still want to join the group today, feel free to do so. And if you haven't signed up but want to join any of the other groups, there is a sign-up sheet in the lobby. And in our prayers this morning, we will add Alan Todd, as well as praying for Buffalo, New York, the shooting there, and an end to racism. So as usual, we end our announcement time with a mission moment prayer, and for this month, it is about foster care. Let us pray. God of compassion, we know you have created every child in your image. As we pray for all children, this month we pray especially for children in foster care. For the children who are coming into foster care, right at this very moment, we pray for their safety and care, as well as for loving relationships with caseworkers, foster parents, and families. For those aging out of foster care, we pray that they are embraced by loving communities and support. And as they move to the next phase in their lives, they feel this love and support in their journey forward. Provide funding and resources to agencies that support foster care. Open our hearts here at St. Paul so that we continue to answer the call to be the loving support to children in foster care, embracing them in all times with grace and mercy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And so as we prepare ourselves for worship and listening to the prelude, you may want to take a moment and think about what talent and things you want to put down on the sheet of paper.
Thank you.
thanksgiving for baptism. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the fountain of living water, the rock who gave us birth, our light and our salvation. Water, water, we praise you, O God, for water, the rain that nourishes animals and plants, the water for drinking and bathing. We praise you, O God, for water.
We praise you, O God, for water.
We praise you, O God, for our water stories, a flood that cleansed the earth, the sea that drowned the enemy, a river that healed the leprosy. We praise you, O God, for water. We remember the waters of Jesus, baptized in the Jordan River, calming the Sea of Galilee, drinking from Jacob's well, healing at the pool of Bethesda, washing the disciples' feet. We praise you, O God, for water.
We praise you, O God, for water.
We praise you, O God, for this font, for through this water you have birthed us into the family of Christ, bathed us in forgiveness, and enlivened us in the Spirit. We praise you, O God, for baptism.
We praise you, O God, for baptism.
O God, you are the ocean, sustaining the earth. O God, you are the river, saving us from death. O God, you are the fountain, granting us health and well-being. We praise you, O God, today, tomorrow, forever. Amen and amen.
Amen
and
amen.
We'll stand for the
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Go! Woo! Look at this! We've got some stretching, jumping jacks, we've got a plank, toes. I had in mind. Okay, ready? I'm going to teach you how to jog in place. Okay, so you're standing nice and tall. You raise one leg. Okay, then you raise the other. Then the other. Come, Marcus, you can do it. Ready? And then go faster and faster and faster and faster until you're running in place. Woo! Good job. So, was it easy for you to think of the move that I was going to show you before I showed you? No, it's almost impossible, right? That's your mind reader. Would it have been easier if I had showed you first and then you could follow?
Yes,
of course. So, come join me on the steps. You get a break from all that working out. That was great. So, in today's scripture story, Jesus is teaching his disciples a new rule. He tells them to love one another as I have loved you. A very important thing about this rule is that Jesus was already living that rule. He had already shown his disciples how to love one another because he had already been loving them. And because Jesus loved first, then the disciples were able to see and know what he meant when he said, "As I have loved you." Here are some of the loving actions that Jesus did for his disciples. He invited them to be his students, and he wanted to spend time with them. He shared stories with them to help them better understand God. And he showed them how to talk and listen to God, what we call praying. And you know what? If we read all the stories about Jesus, then we too can see these same actions that Jesus showed his disciples. In this way, Jesus also shows us how to be his students. And because we can see how Jesus showed the love to his disciples, then we can see how we are to love one another, just like Jesus loved his disciples. And as Jesus' disciples, then because Jesus loved us first, we know how to love others like Jesus does. And that's the good news for today. So will you pray with me? Repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for Jesus, who shows your love to his disciples so that they and we can see how to then share your love with others.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The first reading from Acts 11. Now the apostles and the believers who were in Judea heard that the Gentiles had also accepted the word of God. So when Peter went to Jerusalem, the circumcised believers criticized him, saying, "Why did you go uncircumcised with uncircumcised men and eat with them?" Then Peter began to explain to them, step by step, saying, "I was in the city of Joppa, praying and in a trance, I saw a vision. It was something like a large sheep coming down from heaven, being lowered by its four corners. And it came close to me. And as I looked at it closely, I saw four-footed animals, beasts of prey, reptiles, and birds of the air. I also heard a voice saying to me, 'Get up, Peter, kill and eat.' But I replied, 'By no means, Lord, for nothing profane or unclean has ever entered my mouth.' But a second time, the voice answered from heaven, 'What God has made clean, you must not call it profane.' This happened three times. Then everything was pulled up again to heaven. At that very moment, three men sent to me from Caesarea arrived at the house where we were. The Spirit told me to go with them and not to make a distinction between them and us. These six brothers also accompanied me. When we entered the man's house, he told us how he had seen the angel standing in his house and saying, 'Send to Joppa and bring Simon, who is called Peter. He will give you a message by which you and your entire household will be saved.' And as I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell upon them, just as it had fallen upon us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said, John baptized with water, but you will baptize with the Holy Spirit. If then God gave them the same gift that he gave us when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was that I could hinder God? When they heard this, they were silenced, and they praised God, saying, then God has given even to the Gentiles the repentance that leads to life. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
All right. Psalm 148. Hallelujah, praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise God in the heights.
Praise the Lord, all you angels. Sing praise, all you hosts of heaven.
Praise the Lord, sun and moon. Sing praise, all you shining stars.
Praise the Lord, heaven and heavens, and you are so all heavens.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, who commanded, and they were created. Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all deeps.
Fire and hail, snow and fog, tempestuous winds, wind and
mountains and all the hills, fruit trees and all cedars.
Wild beasts and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds.
Sovereigns of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the world.
Young men and maidens, old and young together.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, whose name is only exalted, whose splendor is over earth and heaven.
The Lord has raised up strength for the people and praise for all faithful servants. The children of Israel, a people who are near the Lord. Hallelujah.
Second reading from Revelation chapter 21. I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea saw no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven of God, prepared as a bride adorned by her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, see, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away. And the one who was seated at the throne, see, I am making all things new. And he also said, write this, for these words are trustworthy and true. Then he said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Rise for the reading of the Gospel. Holy Gospel according to John, the 13th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When he had gone out, Jesus said, Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God had been glorified in him, God would also glorify him in himself, and would glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Love is a powerful word in the English language, but there seem to be a whole lot of different ways of defining what that word means. It will not come as a surprise that the most common definition of the word love has to do with the relationship between two persons. There are, of course, a whole lot of other definitions of the word love as well. But however we define this word, I think we can safely say that we all want to be in relationship with others in a loving way. Into all of this confusion and the different definitions of the word love comes Jesus. He has a wonderful way of knowing what humanity wants and what we need and to which he responds. For example, in our world there are many people who thirst. Is it ever wonder that Jesus tells us that he is the living water? There are so many of us who have hunger for something more profound than the everyday life we slug through. So Jesus tells us that he is the bread of life. John's Gospel is a marvelous example of the way that Jesus uses everyday illustration to describe himself in relation to what we want out of life, much like Suzanne talked about in her time with the children. And his life is a wonderful illustration of that word love. In Jesus' teaching, love is the theme that he talks about the most, as a matter of fact. But the love he talks about and lives out is much different than how we tend to define it ourselves. The love Jesus teaches us about has all to do with relationships. Relationships built on Christ's love. A love that gives us the power to enter into relationships with others around us. And we do that in the way we relate to others from all walks of life, all races, all religions and faith groups. In other words, Jesus teaches us that we are to love just the way that he loves us. And the way that Jesus loves humanity is much different than how we tend to love each other as well. His love consisted of reaching out to humanity and embracing a world that needs to be embraced. Those in need, the forgotten, the outcast. The Apostle Paul, in his writing, often translates Jesus' concept of love into three things: compassion, hope, and faith. Compassion that we will be loved, not for the way the magazines tells us we have to look, but for who we are as a human being and a child of God. Hope that someone will want to see us as a child of God, and in that embrace us, care for us and love us, just as we embrace them, care for them, and love them. Faith that the relationship we enter into will be lasting relationships. Compassion, hope, and faith. Isn't this what we want to experience and have others see in us? Jesus knows that is what humanity wants, and that is what we want to give others. So in today's Gospel text, set at the table during the Last Supper before his betrayal and death, Jesus tells us that love and mutual respect for one another is not only the way it should be, but the way it must be if we follow God. And so he gives us the power to share that with others by using himself as an example. In Jesus, we learn that our love for one another begins by reaching out to those in society we should not love, or the ones with problems and pains we say cannot be loved. And all of that is summed up in that very last line in our gospel reading for today, where Jesus said, "By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." The compassion, hope, and faith Christians live and show each other is truly then God's love for humanity that we received in the water and word in our baptism. A love through the grace of God that transforms us to show love for others. And what we need to remember is that the flow is always in that direction, from God to us, never the other way around. It is always God's love for us that inspired us to love others. As a matter of fact, it is only because God loves us first that we can love others. So the Apostle Paul understood this concept of God's grace and love in action very well. And he wrote about it in clear and precise ways in his famous first letter to the church in Corinth. He needed to write to them because they were a church that was having a tough time getting along with each other. We know this text as one often used in weddings. I think it is happening because of the traits of love that Paul writes about. So listen to what Paul writes, that love in the church and among members of the church is and isn't, what Christian fellowship is and isn't. He says, love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. The love that really counts is then the sacrificial love that finds itself being part of the relationship that we have with each other. It is also there in the mission we do as a church to those outside of the church community. And for us at St. Paul, this love is lived out in our mission as people who share God's grace through Christ. Love, pray, rejoice, and serve in all aspects of our congregational life and ministry. And it is into this community that we today will welcome Stephanie, Marcus, Cheryl, Colleen, and Jeremy as new members. In this worship, they will affirm the faith to be part of and to share this love of Jesus with those around them, being the living voice of the gospel. And so we need to remember that sacrificial love has no limits. After all, not even death limits God's love. In the Easter season we are in right now, we are reminded of this very thing in every reading that we do in the life of the church. In the giving of his son, Jesus the Christ, the one who went to the cross for our sake, and then rose again from the dead on the third day to give us eternal life, God showed us the ultimate sacrificial love and what it's all about. It is through this gracious gift of God that we can believe and find strength and hope in God. It is through this gracious gift of God we believe in the love God has for us and for all humanity. So yes, Jesus has a wonderful way of knowing what humanity wants and what we need. And so it comes as no surprise that in Jesus' teaching, love is the theme that he talks about the most. The love he talks about is the true love that fills us within, the love that gives us compassion, hope, and faith to reach out to others. And for this gift of love that powers us to reach out to others, all we can say, thanks be to God.
Thank you.
present the members and go to a microphone, and we begin with Dana and Eric Miller. And so as the person is presented, please come forward and stand here by the altar. Either way.
I present Stephanie and Marcus Capps, who wish to make public affirmation of their baptism as they become members of St. Paul Evangelical Lutheran Church.
Cheryl is not able to be here, so Susanna and Rory. You stand down.
We present Colleen and Jeremy Madison, who wish to make public affirmation of their baptism as they become members of St. Paul Evangelical Lutheran Church.
Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you for Stephanie, Marcus, Cheryl, Colleen, and Jeremy, whom you have made your own by water and the word of baptism. You have called them to yourself, enlightened them with the gifts of your Spirit, and nourish them in the community of faith. Uphold your servants in the gifts and promises of baptism, and unite the hearts of all whom you have brought to new birth. We ask this in the name of Christ.
Amen.
So Colleen and Stephanie and Marcus, I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith in the Church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God, the powers of this world that rebel against God, and the ways of sin that draw you from God? And congregation may join in. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified,
God the Holy Spirit. Stephanie, Marcus, Cheryl, Colleen, and Jeremy, who are affirming baptism today, you have made public profession of your faith. Do you intend to continue in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the examples of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth?
And I do, and I ask God to help
today. And you, people of God, do you promise to support Stephanie, Marcus, Cheryl, Colleen, and Jeremy, who are making public affirmation, and who, to pray for them in their life in Christ? We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give us new birth, cleanse us from sin, and raise us to eternal life. Stir up in Stephanie, Marcus, Cheryl, Colleen, and Jeremy the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and light, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. And so if you all turn your pages, then we'll together welcome these new members into our congregation. We welcome you into the membership of our congregation
and into the mission we share, giving thanks and praise to God for your presence among us and the gifts we share.
So we greet them in the past. Has some certificates to hand out, and there are gifts from pieces to with you and from the congregation. I invite the congregation to rise for the prayers of the church. Set free from captivity to sin and death, we pray to the God of resurrection for the church, people in need, and all creation.
Loving God, lead us to follow your Spirit rather than our own prejudices or desires, as the Church cares for one another. Open us to perceive your gifts in those we least expect. We pray for those living with mental illness and for all who work to improve access to mental health care and combat the stigma of mental illness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Inspire us to praise you through the beauty and majesty of the natural world around us. Urge us toward more deliberate care of the world you have made. Extend your loving embrace to all people, creatures, and livelihoods in the path of wildfires in New Mexico, Arizona, Colorado, and elsewhere, and for the safety of those who are fighting the fires. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Humble the rulers of nations before your splendor. Direct them to the people who need their attention most and turn them from the temptation to hoard wealth or power. We pray for the people of Ukraine and for people throughout the world who are endangered by violence and warfare. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hasten to dwell among those who are in pain or distress, especially Sue, Henry, Alan, Jean, Ellen, Brenda, Betty, Mary, Sarah, Linda, Richard, Matthew, Ken, Cheryl, Sarah, Caitlin, Joan, Bill, Connie, Paul, Camille, Trish, Doris, Carl, Lila, Fred, Fern, Rhonda, Travis, Ryan, Kathy, Earl, Paul, Janice, Harry, Lucille, Eleanor, Carl, and Sarah. As Christ enters our deepest suffering, remain with those experiencing despair and great need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Place holy love at the center of all our relationships and communities. By your love, heal us, convict us, and renew us. Bring an end to racism in our churches and communities. We lift in prayer all those who seek healing and comfort through the support groups that meet here each week. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide with the Holy Spirit the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, our National Bishop Elizabeth, and our Southeast Michigan Synod and our Bishop Donald. Sustain the work of your Spirit through our Synod Assembly that met yesterday. Hear our prayers for all congregations in our conference, thinking today especially of St. Mark Lutheran Church in Roseville and their pastor, Reverend George Overly. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In your mercy, O God, respond to these prayers and renew us by your life-giving Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Savior.
Amen.
Peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Share that peace with each other.
Let us pray. Be known to us, O Lord, in the breaking of the bread, as you were made known to the disciples. Receive these gifts and the offering of our lives, that we may be your risen body in the world. Amen. Amen.
Sending all places, give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb, who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter, and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angel and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join with the renovated hymn. We praise you for the grace shown to your people in every age, the promise to Israel, the rescue from Egypt, the gift of the promised land, the words of the prophets, and at this end of all the ages, the gift of your Son, who proclaimed in the good news in word and deed, and was obedient to your will, even to giving his life. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until his coming.
Christ is God. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, O God, with this bread and cup, we remember the life our Lord offered for us, and believing the witness of his resurrection, we await his coming in power to share with us the great and promised feast.
Amen. Amen, Lord Jesus.
Send now, we pray, your Holy Spirit, that we who share in Christ's body and blood may live to the praise of your glory and receive our inheritance with all your saints in life. Join our prayers with those of your servants of every time and place, and unite them with the ceaseless petitions of our great High Priest, until he comes as the victorious Lord of all. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Come to the banquet for all is now ready, and all are welcome. You may be seated.
Thank you.
the body of Christ given for you. And the blood of Christ shed for you. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. Life-giving God, in the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, you send light to conquer darkness, water to give new life, and the bread of heaven to nourish your people. Send us forth as witnesses to Jesus' resurrection, so that we may show your glory to all the world. Through the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated as we call on Pen to tell us the rest of the story.
I'll raise the microphone this time. As you leave, number one, the markers go on the table. Number two, I'll be in the hallway to post your goldenrod or whatever what color you want to call them on the clothesline. Then number three in the Bethany room will be creating faith bowls. Now, if you have a gift of beauty and you want to paint or have fun painting, there are paint brushes and paints. There are paint markers because it's easier to write. There are also a whole lot of decals for people who like to design things that are already done. This is to create a God place in your home. Whether you put it someplace obvious or someplace private. And we'll be adding things to this faith bowl on Faith Life Sundays. There are rocks. Lovingly carried in a suitcase from North Wales that you can paint and decorate this week. And then next month, we will add as we go to our faith bowls. So, come play.
So we have a faith life prayer about this event. God of wisdom, thank you for the many ways you bless our lives. We give thanks today for the talents you have given each and every one of us. Talents that help us to share your love, grace, forgiveness, and peace with others. We ask for your guidance as we wonder and discern how you are calling us to use our gifts in the church, the community, and the other. Help us to hear your call, and help us to be encouraged and courageous in sharing our talents.
Amen.
Amen. And so I invite you to rise for the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Yeah. I'll be there in a minute. I'm working. I'll be out there in a minute.
Out of here.
Oh, sorry.
I want to take a picture of her.